Silhouetted against the sun, the Northrop XP-79 looked like a blade ready to slice through the sky. It was designed just for that, to ram enemy bombers and tear them apart in brutal melee combat. Unlike any other plane of its time, its Starship design was breathtaking for the 1940s. The XP-79 broke the mold in more than just looks. Its bold, otherworldly design and unique configuration, where the pilot lay prone in the cockpit, made for a revolutionary flying experience. The XP-79 was built without a traditional propeller. Instead, it relied on the XLR-2000 A1 rotojet engines developed by Aerojet, a pioneer in jet technology. Adding to its innovation, the XP-79 was one of the first aircraft constructed using a magnesium alloy. This lightweight material was crucial for achieving the high speeds and agility the aircraft demanded. However, this innovation came with a dangerous risk. Magnesium posed significant challenges, including difficulties in welding and increased flammability. Tensions were sky high when the futuristic-looking aircraft rolled onto the tarmac for its first flight. Witnesses had no idea that what was expected to be a massive leap in aviation history was about to end in devastating tragedy. For years, Jack Northrop harbored a wild and seemingly unfeasible idea. What if he could create a flying chainsaw? Imagine a warplane designed to ram enemy bombers and take them out of the sky without relying on gunners or ammunition. This idea emerged as a bold, unconventional solution to the daunting challenge of intercepting and destroying heavily armed enemy bombers. In the early 1940s, Allied forces faced significant difficulties countering the threat posed by well-defended German bombers like the Heinkel He-111 and the Dornier Du-17. These bombers bristled with defensive machine guns, forming a formidable shield against traditional fighter attacks. Their tight formations provided overlapping fields of fire, making it perilous for fighters to penetrate and engage effectively. Anti-aircraft systems of the time also struggled against these bombers due to limitations in accuracy, range, and mobility. High-altitude bombing missions further complicated interception efforts, as conventional fighters had to climb rapidly and contend with the bombers' defensive maneuvers and blistering firepower. Jack Northrop and his team at Northrop Corporation envisioned the XP-79 to address these challenges. This aircraft featured a unique flying wing design, enhancing structural integrity and allowing for greater maneuverability. Constructed primarily from magnesium alloy, the XP-79 was built to withstand high-stress impacts, which is crucial for a ramming aircraft. She was designed to slice through enemy formations like a hot knife through butter, turning the tables on German bombers with sheer audacity and innovative engineering. The Northrop XP-79 wasn't the first aircraft designed with ramming in mind. Earlier examples, like the Soviet Polikarpov 116 during the Winter War and the early stages of World War II, were modified for ramming attacks. However, the XP-79 stood out as purpose-built for this brutal tactic, featuring a reinforced structure specifically for ramming enemy bombers, a more systematic approach to an otherwise desperate maneuver. Despite the obvious fact that any plane involved in a mid-air collision would likely be unable to fly afterward, the project was taken seriously by the Northrop Corporation, who continued pursuing the concept. The XP-79 was to be powered by two Westinghouse 19B turbojets, providing a blistering top speed of approximately 550 miles per hour and a range of 1,000 miles. These specs were intended to enable the XP-79 to quickly reach and engage enemy bombers at high altitudes. The idea behind the XP-79 was to use a reinforced structure to physically ram and disable enemy bombers, inflicting catastrophic damage that conventional machine gun fire might not achieve or only could hope to achieve after numerous passes. This daring tactic aimed to slice through enemy aircraft, causing them to plummet from the sky. The aircraft's design aimed to minimize the risk to the pilot, who would be shielded within the robust airframe. Additionally, the XP-79's agility and speed were intended to outmaneuver the bomber's defensive guns, allowing her to close in for the devastating ramming attack. after Jack Northrop pitched his high-speed rocket-powered flying wing fighter to the United States Army Air Forces, a contract for two prototypes was awarded in January 1943. The mission: develop an aircraft capable of ramming enemy bombers from the sky. Initially, the XP-79 was set to feature two Aerojet Xcalor 2000A1 liquid-fueled rocket engines, each producing 2,000 pounds of thrust. However, these engines proved unsatisfactory, and the decision was made to install two Westinghouse 19B turbojets instead. To test the design, the USAAF contracted Northrop for three gliders. These were dubbed the MX-324 when referring to the secret aspects of its power plant, and the MX-334 when operated as true gliders. The first, MX-334, number 1, underwent wind tunnel testing at the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics Langley Research Center, leading to the addition of a vertical stabilizer for high-speed stability. The number 2 glider participated in the first flight attempts, initially towed by a Cadillac car for takeoffs, landings, and low-level flights. These attempts proved unsuccessful, but subsequent tows with a truck and later a Lockheed P-38 Lightning were more fruitful. In early 1944, the number 2 glider was modified with the Aerojet Xcal 200 rocket. On July 5th, the MX-324 made its maiden flight, becoming the first American-made rocket-powered aircraft to fly. Once flight testing was complete, the other two gliders were discarded. The Northrop XP-79 had an overall length of 13.98 feet, a wingspan of 37.99 feet, and a height of 7.58 feet. Its design resembled a flying wing, similar to the YB-49, featuring a welded magnesium monocoque structure instead of the typical riveted aluminum. The nose housed a central cockpit where the pilot operated in a prone position, enabling them to withstand more G-forces than in a seated position. Two air intakes on either side fed the engines, with its two Westinghouse 19B axial flow turbojets, each producing 1,150 pounds of thrust. The XP-79 could hit a maximum speed of 547 miles per hour and maintain a cruising speed of 480 miles per hour. It had a range of 993 miles and a fuel capacity of 300 gallons, allowing for an endurance of nearly 2.5 hours. This innovative design was as audacious as it was radical, embodying Northrop's vision of an aggressive high-speed interceptor capable of slicing through enemy bombers with devastating precision. Given that the XP-79's main offensive weapon was to ram enemy bombers, ensuring the pilot's safety was paramount. To this end, the cockpit was fitted with armored glass, and armor plating reinforced the wings. The landing gear had a peculiar layout comprising two forward gear legs plus two rear gear legs designed to retract into the wings. The vertical fin was wire-braced for added stability. Another unusual feature was the pilot's prone position in an unpressurized cockpit, accessed via an overhead hatch. The pilot lay on his stomach and his head nestled into an acrylic plastic windshield shielded by a layer of armored glass. Cocooned inside, the pilot controlled the XP-79's pitch and roll with a crossbar control rod while the foot pedals managed the brake. Elevons and air intakes located at the wingtips enabled lateral control. To get inside, the pilot had to awkwardly squeeze up from the trailing edge, face down, and enter the hatch head first. The planned operation was breathtakingly audacious. A typical mission would start with the XP-79 being blasted off using jet-assisted takeoff, JATO packs, as a fleet of enemy bombers approached. The aircraft would then ascend to 40,000 feet, fly above the formation, and dive down to slice off the tail or wing of a bomber with its reinforced structure. Many USAAF officials harbored serious reservations about the project, considering it highly risky. Consequently, it was requested that the XP-79 also be equipped with four 12.7mm Browning M3 machine guns, each with 250 rounds of ammunition situated on the wing center section. This addition aimed to provide a more conventional means of attack, ensuring the XP-79 had a fighting chance if the ramming tactic proved impractical. Despite the reservations, the project moved forward to the testing phase. In January 1943, A contract was awarded for the construction of 3 units. But due to developmental problems with the rocket engines, only one XP-79 was ever made. Its existence would be tragically short-lived. 2 initial tests were canceled before the aircraft could take off due to burst tires and brake problems during taxiing trials at Muroc Dry Lake. Still, the red flags were ignored, and the path toward its maiden flight continued. The XP-79, painted white and marked with the serial number 43-52437, was loaded onto a truck, concealed beneath a canvas sheet, and transported to Muroc Dry Lake for flight assessment. The pilot, Harry Crosby, who planned to retire to his farm in California after the test, was to be at the helm. On September 12, 1945, the XP-79 began its fateful journey. Accelerating down the runway, it narrowly avoided an Army fire truck that had unwittingly moved into its path. The aircraft lifted off and climbed to 10,000 feet at 400 miles per hour. About 15 minutes into the flight, Crosby attempted a turning maneuver. The operation went terribly wrong in an instant as the XP-79 entered a nose-down spin, eerily similar to the MX-324's fate. Crosby fought to regain control, but the plane remained unresponsive as if it had a mind of its own. With the ground rushing up to meet him, Crosby made a desperate decision. He climbed out of the plummeting aircraft and leaped into the open sky. Time seemed to slow down as he fell, but just as he was about to open his parachute, the rotating wings struck him, and he perished instantly. The XP-79 collided with the ground and burst into a ferocious blaze thanks to burning magnesium. This disaster marked the end of USAF and Northrop's venture into such perilous designs. The Northrop XP-79 left a lasting impact and inspired other aircraft designs despite its untimely demise. The audacious and inventive ideas of the XP-79 cleared the path for developments in aviation technology and design, impacting the creation of both military and commercial aircraft. The flying wing design of the XP-79 was one of its greatest accomplishments. It eventually impacted the creation of more sophisticated flying wing aircraft. Jack Northrop strongly supported this idea, and it was finally implemented in the Northrop YB-49 and the B-2 Spirit stealth bomber. The flying wing design provided advantages in aerodynamics and stealth, as well as increased fuel efficiency and decreased radar cross-section, all crucial elements in modern military aircraft. Furthermore, despite its difficulties, the XP-79's use of magnesium alloy demonstrated the possibilities of lightweight materials in aircraft design. Modern airplanes are made of sophisticated composites and alloys thanks to the aerospace industry's continuous search for stronger and lighter materials, which was aided by these novel material experiments. Another example of the value of creative propulsion systems was the XP-79. Even though turbojets were used in place of rocket engines at first, the project demonstrated the possibilities of jet propulsion, which is now the norm for high-speed, high-altitude aircraft. A turning point in the history of aviation was the transition from propeller-driven to jet-powered aircraft, which paved the way for the creation of faster and more effective aircraft. Furthermore, the XP-79's focus on pilot safety and its unusually prone posture affected the design of cockpits for other high-performance aircraft. The design of later military aircraft placed a strong emphasis on ensuring pilot safety while optimizing performance, which resulted in improvements to pilot ejection mechanisms and cockpit ergonomics. The creation of flying wing aircraft, the use of cutting-edge materials, the switch to jet power, and the emphasis on pilot safety are all examples of its legacy and the long-lasting effects of this risky undertaking.